Good morning, class. Good morning. Come on in. Happy Halloween. You are all looking so spooky, scary in your costumes. I love it. Good, 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 good. Everybody, go ahead. Find the seat with your name on it. Every seat has got a paper pumpkin with a name written on it. See if you can find yours. If you're having any trouble, let me know. I can help you find it. Yes, Molly, yours is over here to the left. You've got it. And anybody else? Rami? Mm-hmm. Over here on the right, up front by me. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Everyone is settled in, hands in laps for roll call. Perfect. Let's make sure everyone's here. We know we've got Molly and Rami, but how about Tamika? Does anybody see Tamika? There she is. Good. And Jimmy. Now that we know everyone is here, we can get started looking at our schedule today. Very special and exciting schedule because it's a holiday. So we're gonna do a whole bunch of fun stuff, and then you get to go home early to enjoy the festivities further with your family. Whatever you guys like to do, your holiday traditions, carving pumpkins, maybe going to a haunted house, maybe getting ready for trick-or-treating. So, from 8 to 10, we're doing craft tables. Each table around the room has a bunch of supplies set up on it. Everything that you'll need to make one very cool Halloween craft. First, the craft of the table that you're currently sitting at. And then whenever you're done, you get to get up, pick another table, have a seat, do that craft. Keep going until I call recess at 10, where you'll get to run around on the playground, show off your costume, see what everybody else is dressed up as. As per usual, you guys will have 15 minutes to run around to your heart's content until you hear the whistle, which means you file back inside one by one, single file, to receive your party favor bag filled to the brim with Halloween goodies. Welcome, have a seat on the carpet for our 10:15 story time circle. And you guys will get to pick which Halloween storybook you would like me to read for you. You'll have some time to explore all the treasures in your treat bags. And then I'm going to put on a movie. And while the movie is playing, anybody who would like to have their face painted can come up to my desk. Use my paints to decorate your face with some sweet little designs that will go along with your costume, okay? And last of all, we will all enjoy a big, delicious potluck and your parents will come pick you up, and you'll go trick-or-treating, collect all the candy that you can carry. How does that sound? Does anybody have any questions? Make the rounds around the room, have a little visit with each table, and give you guys a demonstration of how to make the craft of your table and help out anybody who's struggling, okay? Good, let's get started. Hello, 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 table number one. It looks like you guys are making ghosts. However you please, pulling and prodding until it looks just how you want it. Then we'll need to grab a Sharpie to make his face. To make his expression, you can either do it all with Sharpie, or we can glue on some googly eyes. I think this sounds like more fun, don't you? Let's give him some extra personality. So in that case, we'll need the glue.
The Googles.
Googles, Googles, Googles. We've got so many different colors to choose from. I think I'm gonna do red. I want my ghost to be kind of spooky, scary. A lot of them are too big. Like this one, that's not gonna fit on our lollipop. So we've got to do a little bit of searching around. Perfect. And then sticking on the eye, like that, and like that. There he is. And finally, our finishing touch is going to be the mouth, right there. Move on to whatever craft looks fun whenever you're ready, okay? Hello, 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 table number two. You guys have got light brights. Has everybody used one of these before? Okay, alright, so a few of you have one at home. So if not, all you need to do is pick which colors you want middle of the table and place the bags wherever you would like them to create a design. So the example that we have here is a moon, a crescent moon with a jack-o'-lantern, and finally are really cool because you can make whatever design you want and then just flip the switch on the back to make it all come to life, to light it up and make it glow. So let me know if any of you would like some assistance with your design. If you need more of a certain color, I can go fetch some extra bags from behind the whiteboard, all right? Hello, 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 table number three. 1, 2, 3. You guys have got a very fun but very messy task at hand. You guys are making slime. So you've got all the ingredients you need to make whichever kind of slime you like. We have sparkles and sequins, or we've got witch's brew. I like how this one has got star-shaped sequins inside. Do y'all see that? I'm gonna put this in the middle of the table so y'all can get a closer look. Last color, I like to call this one Magic Spell. It's a pretty, pretty, pretty purple. So, going to go ahead and show you all how to make a slime. But it's very important that when you start making your own, that you make sure that everything is going on top of your mat. Each and every one of you has got your own moon and star mat sitting in front of you, which is very easy for Miss Moon to clean up any mess that might happen. Messes happen, we can't help it. And it's okay if it gets on the floor or anywhere else, but just know it's a big help for Miss Moon to try to keep any messes Elmer's washable clear glue into everybody's cup. Okay. so good. We don't want to have any clumps sticking out. Perfectly smooth. How's it looking for everybody? Is anyone having trouble with clumps? Okay. Yep. Just keep mixing. Everybody's is looking great. You guys are very good mixers. One, two, three. Drops into my slime. Not more than that, or else you can start running into trouble with the dye staining your hands when you're playing with the slime, and that's no fun. Going to mix dye in there. And to spice it up, you can add in some glitter. We've got all kinds of different colors to choose from. You can just sprinkle that in. And mix it up with a magic ingredient that's going to transform this humble very well on their own. They can either wear glasses or contact lenses. They're kind of like little glasses that go directly onto your eyes, but you have to take them out at night. And to keep them nice and fresh and moist, them sit in this stuff overnight. But for slime, there's a special you want. I think I'm going to do quite a cute little pumpkin face. Crescent moons for the eyes. A little triangle nose. And a nice we want to fill in our paper in half. Once again, not hamburger style, but hot dog style. Everybody can grab their pair of scissors. And we're going to make finishing up the other half. Have a somewhat rounded shape, like a real jack-o'-lantern, which you'll see when we roll it up like that. And we want other shapes with your leftover green construction paper, like some leaves or vines. And then your pumpkin lantern is complete. Everybody's is looking great. I love yours, Fledger. He looks very spooky. Let's see. Eloise, very adorable. We will need to glue it together. I'm going to paint them all black with a brush and acrylic paint, making sure that we are getting every single nook and cranny in both sides. Now we want to take a link. Your spider can be any color you want. It can be sparkly. It can be striped. It can be neon. It can be glittery. Peppermint. Absolutely anything you please. So we just want to nestle our little spider into his new home. Finish him off with the googly eyes of your choice. Hello, 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 everyone. You guys are making paper dolls. This is really fun, and you can make anything you like. Pumpkins, ghosts, cats, spiders, if you're feeling brave. All you need to do is choose you would like and fold it accordion style until it looks something like this. Does everybody have it all folded accordion style? Good, good, good. Good, 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 good. Right. Next step is going to be to grab a Sharpie and draw what design of dolls you'd like. So really the only requirement here is that the edges have to touch like that. Your edges have to connect. Besides that, you can do whatever you like. Now we need to cut him out. Then what should happen, as long as you kept your edges connected, is we'll fold out like that to make lots of copies of your little friends. So I'm going to go back in and add faces to everybody. So maybe next we could do an angry ghost. Their paper dolls. We can string these up across the room, or you can keep them to yourself if you'd like to play with them. Okay. Hello, hello, hello. The craft at this table is very simple. We've got Peel and Stick, Moody Monsters. So all of the shapes are already pre-sliced into these colorful foam sheets, and you can mix and match them however you want to make them happy, surprise, silly, sad, angry, whatever you want. Everybody get a goodie bag on their way in. Perfect. Everybody's goodie bag has some puzzles on the side, like this crossword, this connect the dots, a word search, find the differences, and my personal favorite, coloring. Everybody's bag has got different designs. Like this one has a stack of jackals. this one has got the cutest trick-or-treating ghost. Should we see what you guys have got inside? Go ahead and have a look first. Everybody got lots of glow sticks. So many glow sticks, can you believe it? These are great for trick-or-treating. You can put them around your wrists, your ankles, your neck, your head. These are really good for making sure can see when you're walking around in the dark, okay? So these are super good for fun and for safety. Crack them like that. Not too hard because you don't want them to break, but bend it just enough so you can hear the snap. Everybody gets some fresh pencils. Cool designs like pumpkin. You could trade pencils with your friends around you if you don't like your designs, but I think they're all very beautiful. Some bubble stickers. You can put these on your folder, your binder, your notebooks. I like this one that's got the lollipops. 1, 2, 3. Or the cauldron. Well, as these jack-o'-lantern erasers, you get 1, 2, 3 of these. Everybody got a few stamps. Each of these has its own design, and they come with the ink already in there. All you need to do witch's hat. The purple one has a ghost. Let's see, we've got a spider or a bat. There's so many different possibilities. Now I'm going to get the movie set up while you guys are exploring your treat bags. And then once the movie starts playing, anybody who is interested in getting their face painted is completely welcome to come have a seat at my desk. Okay, good. Hi there, you look amazing. Are you a scarecrow? I love it. What a beautiful costume. Where did you get that? Thrift shopping with your mom? That sounds like so much fun. Brushes right here. What would you think of if I were to put a couple of patches on your face? Like we could do a triangle patchwork nose with some stitches, a few stitches around your mouth, and then maybe a square or a circle patch on your cheek or your forehead. What would you think? I think it'll look great. going to grab a smaller brush. Pick that up and do a square shape on your forehead like that. Filling that in. Paint, paint, paint. And then the finishing touch is going to be to go in with my special detail brush, and we're going to take black. We're going to outline everything. We're going to add stitches. Okay, so I've got the black on my brush, and on your nose we're going to do your mouth like this. Stitch, 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 stitch. I think you're all done. What do you think? Is there anything else that you would like for me to add? Okay. I hope you'll enjoy the rest of the movie. Thanks for letting me paint your face. Great. I wanted to paint face too much. You know, it tickles, and without thinking about it, I'll just sort of brush my hand against my cheek. So I knew that I was just gonna end up with smudges all over my face, and you guys would all giggle at me. Let's do some whiskers next. Smudge that over your eyes. So if you could close your eyes for me, just like that. Good, 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 good. Smudge, 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 smudge. Punch, 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 punch. Oh, you look even scarier than before, and I didn't even think it was possible.